Hey guys, Henry here. This is my guide to the Frost two-handed priority system. First thing you want to do on engaging a boss is apply your outbreak, which will apply both of your diseases to your damage causes, and then proceed to obliterate all your runes onto cooldown. Once those have gone onto cooldown, you'll want to use your Rime proc and proceed to Frost Strike and Frost Strike down your runic power that you've generated. Once you've got enough so that you don't cap your runic power, you want to start obliterating again, as that's your priority move. If you've got a toss up between a killing machine, obliterate, or killing machine, Frost Strike, you'll want to do the obliterate, as it'll do more damage when it crits. We'll move on to the next step. As a Frost DK, you've got two cooldowns, Summon Ghoul and Pillar of Frost. What I do is use two obliterates to get my runes on cooldown, after applying my diseases, of course. And then Pillar of Frost and summon my Ghoul, because the Ghoul benefits from the strength bonus that your Pillar of Frost gives you. From there, you proceed like normal and just do the rotation. Your priority is obliterate, then Frost Strike to make sure you don't cap your runic power, Rime procs. If you can't do anything else, use Horn of Winter, and you just keep going like that. If you notice there, when all my runes were on cooldown, I used my Empower Runic Blade, which meant that all my runes came back off cooldown. I've also got my Rune Tap macroed into my Pillar of Frost, so when I ever need a Pillar of Frost, it will automatically Rune Tap and make sure a rune's available for me to put the Pillar of Frost on instantly, because it's what keeps our DPS sustained. And that's about it, really. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments below. I've got a new website, check that out, and subscribe if you want anything more. Thanks, guys.